Dear students, welcome to this second video of second series. In this video, we are going to learn about the life and achievements of two great contemporary Indian scientists, the Nobel laureate Sir C.V. Raman and the father of Indian nuclear program Dr. Homi Jahangir Bhabha. So let us start this presentation. Chandrasekhar Venkat Raman. He was born on 7th November 1888 at Trichurapalli, which is in Tamil Nadu. His father's name was Chandrasekhar Iyer, who was lecturer in physics. So already in his surrounding, in his home, there was an environment of science. His mother's name was Parvati Amma. He passed MSc in 1907 with the highest distinction from University of Madras at just an age of 19 years. So you can see the brilliance was starting to show from there only. What were the achievements? He passed civil services exam and joined as deputy auditor general at Calcutta. He became the first, but basically you would see that this job of auditor general is like an accountant, or you can say it is an administrative type of post. But he was a scientist because he had a craving for science. Therefore, he was not satisfied with this job and he resigned from this job of deputy auditor general in 1917, and then he applied for professorship in University of Calcutta and he was appointed as the first palate professor of physics in University of Calcutta. During this tenure only, he discovered the Raman effect in 1928. And ultimately, he was awarded the Nobel Prize for his discovery of Raman effect in 1930. Continuing on the achievement, Chandrasekhar Venkat Raman, he was elected as the Fellow of Royal Society in 1924. He was given knighthood in 1929 and therefore we say Sir C.V. Raman. He was awarded Franklin Medal in 1941. And of course, in 1930, he was given the Nobel Prize for Raman effect or Raman scattering. In 1954, he was conferred Bharat Ratna, one of the highest civilian honor given by Indian government. In 1957, he was awarded Lenin Peace Prize. Lenin Peace Prize is given to that statesman or scientist or a person who works for the unity of nation, for bringing peace among the nation. And as you all know that India celebrates the National Science Day on 28th Feb. Why? Because to honor the discovery and the contribution of Sir C.V. Raman, because on 28th Feb 1928 he discovered Raman effect, right? Therefore, to honor the contribution of Sir C.V. Raman, we celebrate 28th February as National Science Day. Now, the research work which he did, of course, the most important which won him the Nobel Prize was Raman effect. But what is most important is, as there were no scientific, that means sophisticated research institutes or labs in that ancient time in India, he used only instruments which were costing merely 200 rupees to make this discovery. This is a fact which is worth mentioning. The scientific research, he also did scientific research on magnetic field and X-rays, that is on electromagnetic rays. He also did research on the structure of crystals, which is known as crystallography. He worked on Indian and Western musical instruments and discovered the harmonic nature of sound. He also explained the reason for the blue color of sea and sky. He once went for a voyage, sea voyage, and he observed the color of the ocean water was blue, and of course the sky also is blue, and he thought about why the color of ocean water always seems to be blue, and he went into the details and he came up with the explanation that this is because of the scattering of light by the atmospheric gases. Now when we want to define what is Raman effect in a layman's language, in simple language, if we want to define, if we want to know about what is Raman effect, let me try. Raman effect is basically when an incident light passes through a transparent sample of a chemical substance, right? Now this chemical substance can be in solid, liquid or even gaseous state, but it should be transparent. Then the light after passing through, when it comes out of that substance, right, that light basically is changed in property, its wavelength changes. Now this change in the property of light or the wavelength of the light is basically because of the properties of that particular medium or that particular chemical substance. Now this change or this change in wavelength or this change in the property of light after passing through that particular chemical substance is a signature of that chemical substance through which it is known against a reference. This is known as the Raman effect in its simple form. Now what is the standard definition? When radiation pass through a transparent medium, the species present scatter a fraction of the light in different direction. Now in 1928, the Indian physicist C.V. Raman discovered that the physical wavelength of a small fraction of the radiation scattered by certain molecule differ from that of the incident beam, and furthermore that the shift in the wavelength, that means the change in the wavelength, depends upon the chemical nature of the molecule responsible for the scattering. That means it depends on the nature of the sample, nature of the medium or the substance through which the light has. We are talking so much of Raman effect. Now why Raman effect is so important for all of us? Let us go into the applications of Raman effect so that you can understand that it is applied in so much diverse field. It is useful in so many fields. So let us see what are the applications of Raman effect. Technique gives us or can generate the fingerprint of universe. That means it is used for exploration of universe. Universe, that means stars, planets, all the origin of universe, the composition of universe, that means the fingerprint of universe can be understood by the techniques of Raman effect. Raman spectroscopy is used for material analysis in the chemical field, in the chemistry, quantitative chemistry, qualitative chemistry. Raman spectroscopy is used for identification of chemical substances and their properties, structure. Raman scanners are now used in the medical, biomedical fields for diagnosing disease cell or organs. Even they are now used for diagnosing the cancer tumors also. Detection of explosives. It can detect chemical substances, therefore it can detect explosives also. So it is used in defense forces, in bomb defusal squads for detection of explosives, etc. Detection of drugs such as steroid, cocaine, etc. So once again, because it can do chemical analysis, therefore it can, that is the alkaloids which are present in steroids or cocaine, such type of addictive substance, it can easily analyze. Non-destructive examination of chemical analysis, because it does not require it, this technique of analysis of chemical analysis through the Raman effect does not require the sample to be broken down. Only the sample should be transparent and only the light passes. So it is non-destructive examination for chemical analysis. Now force constant and bond length, that means once again a chemical analysis of or the structure of the crystal substances, gas analysis for anesthesia. Okay, so all these basically are the applications of Raman effect. Now because of these application, in which field it is used? It is used in pharmaceutical and biomedical field. It is used in material science, that means once again chemical science, nanotechnology, forensic, anti-crime, anti-terrorist. Forensic means jab kahin pe crime ho jata hai, fir usko pakadne ke liye hamare paas jo saboot hote hain uski chemical analysis karte hain, तो वो फॉरेंसिक साइंस है. एंटी क्राइम, जेमोलॉजी, जियोलॉजी, मिनरलॉजी, जेमोलॉजी रत्न में कौन सी चीज़ें कैसी हैं वो सारे, जियोलॉजी, मिनरलॉजी, देन आर्कियोलॉजी, आर्ट, हेरिटेज, इन सब फील्ड्स के अंदर रमन इफेक्ट का, रमन स्पेक्ट्रोस्कोपी का, रमन स्कैटरिंग का, इन सब चीज़ों का यूज़ होता है. एंड दैट इज़ वाई स्टिल दिस रमन इफेक्ट इज मोर एंड मोर नाउ इट इज़ बींग यूज. It is used more and more. Now the second scientist, contemporary scientist, which we are going to discuss about and learn about his life and his contribution is Dr. Homi Jahangir Bhabha. Dr. Homi Jahangir Bhabha was born on 30th October 1909 in a prosperous Parsi family and he was related to Tatas. Tatas ko Bharat mein ya pure vishv mein kaun nahi janta. Aur jo ye Homi Jahangir Bhabha jo the ye कि ये पारसी फैमिली से थे और टाटास भी पारसी हैं, ये दोनों आपस में इनका रिलेशन था. ही वेंट अब्रॉड, ही वॉज गुड इन स्टडीज़ एंड ही वेंट अब्रॉड टू कैम्ब्रिज यूनिवर्सिटी फॉर हायर स्टडीज़. इन 1930 ही कंप्लीटेड हिज डिग्री इन मैकेनिकल इंजीनियरिंग. सो ही वॉज अ मैकेनिकल इंजीनियर. अनफॉर्चुनेटली ही डाइड इन अ प्लेन क्रैश नियर माउंट ब्लैंक जर्मनी ऑन 24 जनवरी 1966. वेरी अनफॉर्चुनेट फॉर इंडिया, स्पेशली इंडिया. Now what was his achievement, why we are remembering the contribution of Dr. Bhabha? Because he has contributed, right? So what are the achievements? Achievements of Dr. Homi Jahangir Bhabha: he discovered nuclear particles known as mesons and he studied the cascade theory of electron shorts. He was instrumental in establishment of Tata Institute of Fundamental Research. As you know that before independence, India became very poor in science, but even in 1945, when India was still under the British rule, he was instrumental in establishment of Tata Institute of Fundamental Research. He was appointed, when India became independent, he was appointed as the first chairman of Atomic Energy Commission in 1948. Further, he was appointed the director of nuclear program in India. So this is a big achievement for him, and therefore he is known as the father of Indian nuclear program. He is known as the father of Indian nuclear program. Dr. Bhabha was appointed then the chairman of the International Atomic Energy Conference held in 1956, in which 81 nations took part. So this is of utmost importance, when 81 nations, and many nations were the developed nations like USA, USSR, all these nations were there in this International Atomic Energy Conference, which was held in 1956. So even in these 81 nation, he was appointed, an Indian scientist was appointed as the chairman, and which is basically a big, we can say, reputation which Dr. Homi Jahangir Bhabha held, and that is why he was appointed the chairman. Dr. Homi Jahangir Bhabha was conferred Padma Bhushan in 1954. Once again, a very distinguished civilian honor, Padma Bhushan, right, in 1954. In 1967, after his death, the Atomic Energy Establishment Trombay was renamed as Bhabha Atomic Research Center, BARC, in his honor. Dr. Bhabha was not only a scientist but also an artist. His painting, drawing, sketches, he was also interested in opera music, and his sketches and paintings and several drawings are still exhibited in London Art Gallery. Now, what is the major contribution of Dr. Homi Jahangir Bhabha? This contribution many times people do not know, but I want to bring it to the light, why Homi Jahangir Bhabha is known as the father of Indian nuclear program. So he realized the potential of India's large thorium reserve in addition to the country's small uranium deposits. So basically, when we say nuclear program, the element which comes to our mind is uranium, but India has very, very rare, that means very less amount of uranium deposits. So if we create more amount of nuclear reactors, more nuclear powerhouses, then we will need more amount of uranium as fuel, and we have to import this uranium from the other countries, right? But he was the scientist who knew that India had less amount of uranium, so he was discovering a technique. He was working on a technique in which directly uranium is not required, thorium is converted into uranium. He was discovering a process in which thorium would be converted to uranium, right? He was working on that technique. The total reserves of thorium in India is about 5 lakh tons in the readily extractable form, while the known reserves of uranium are less than 10th of this. The aim of the long range atomic power program in India must therefore be to base the nuclear power generation as soon as possible on thorium rather than uranium. And that is why he was made the chairman of nuclear program in India, because he was the scientist. He had the ability to devise such processes in which thorium as a nuclear fuel could be used to generate power, right? Because India has very less amount of uranium. So this was the contribution of Dr. Homi Jahangir Bhabha. And this is the end of the presentation. Thank you very much, and I hope that this presentation is informative to you and you have learnt about these two contemporary great Indian scientists. Thank you.